In this tutorial, you'll learn how to make this 4-in-1 slide transition using just a few effects. By hand creating transitions, you'll have the ability to make tweaks and give them a customized look. You'll learn how to save this transition as an animation preset and bring it into any project with just a few clicks, so all of your hard work won't go to waste. Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This transition tutorial will help you develop skills using adjustment layers, saving and using animation presets, and using a combination of effects that you may not have even known were possible. You'll learn skills and techniques that you can use every day at your job, for your clients, and in your own personal projects. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a Shape Layer Rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project file and presets for this episode can all be found in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through. So let's dive right in. All right, so I have these two clips right here. You can use any two clips you would like. Our midpoint is at our 2-second mark. So right-click in this area that's to the left of your timeline. Choose New, Adjustment Layer. And we're just going to rename this to Transition. With your playhead at the 2-second mark, Option or Alt left bracket trims your layer to where your playhead is. This is going to be a 20-frame animation. So Shift page down 1-2 times to go for 20 frames, and then Alt or Option click your right bracket to trim your out point to where your playhead is. So let's move our midpoint right here to where these two clips meet. So make sure that you have this transition layer selected and go over to your effects and presets panel, and then start typing the effects that we need. So I'm going to type in motion tile and then just double click motion tile. Then let's just type transform, double click where it says distort, transform, fast box, and choose our fast box blur. And the last one we need is a glow. So let's type in glow. I have a lot of glow presets. So the one we're looking for is this last one, this stylized glow. So double click that. Now if we go over to our effects control panel over here, we can see all of our effects came in. So I'm just going to click on any one of these and Command or Control A to select them all and then close them up. So now make sure your playhead is at your 2-second mark, because that's where we need to drop our keyframes initially. First, let's open up motion tile, and we're just going to change our output width to 200, height to 200, and mirror edges. The reason why I want to change this to 200 is because we need both our width and our height to be double our clip. So these video clips are 1920 by 1080, but we need to expand our output width, double the length of that size, and our height, double the height of that size. Okay, so let's close up motion tile and go down to transform. The only thing we'll be needing to change is this position. So let's put a keyframe here for position. So let's go ahead and close that up. Fast box blur. We want to change blur radius to 130 and put a keyframe there. And then let's change this blur dimensions from horizontal and vertical. Just change it to horizontal for now. Close that up and go to glow. And then let's change our threshold to 0%. And then we want to change our glow intensity to 0.8 and put a keyframe there. So for now, let's go ahead and hide our glow and blur. With transition selected, press U to bring up our keyframes. Let's put a marker where all of these keyframes are, so hit the asterisk button, and we have this marker right here. That's going to indicate where our midpoint is and also where this second clip needs to begin. Okay, and then let's go back one frame and pull our transform keyframe back. So that way the position keyframe is one frame in front of these other keyframes. Press I, it goes back to the beginning of our layer. We want our beginning position to be 960 by 540. So just add another keyframe there. So that way these two keyframes are the same for now. Okay, for fast box blur, let's change this value down to 0. And for glow intensity, let's change this value down to 0 as well. So now let's focus on this position keyframe here. We want to change this position from 960 by 540 to 0 540. Now, so if we kind of scrub through here, we can see how this clip is going to move to the left right here. And we see what our motion tile effect is doing. It's doubling the width of this clip. And that's because it's set at this 200 value. So now let's go to where our midpoint is. And now we're going to change our position again. We're going to change our value to 1920 and then go to the very end by pressing O and then make our position 960. So let's go through and kind of talk about what's going on here. So our last keyframe is 96540. Our first keyframe is 96540. So as we scrub through here, we can see how it's moving to the left, and then it jumps to the right of the next clip and brings it in. This is constantly moving left because our value for position is 960, moving down to zero, and then it jumps to 1920, which is to the right of our comp, and then it moves into the left. Okay, and then we can just grab these other two keyframes and copy paste, so that way these first and last keyframes are the same. To highlight all of these keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. Then we want to select the first group of keyframes, go to our graph editor, and bring in all of our handles. And do the same thing in the opposite direction for our last set of keyframes, and pull those over to the left. Okay, so now we can turn back on these effects for fast box blur and for glow. And then let's just watch that playback. And this is the effect we have. So it animates off to the left and brings our second clip in from the right. Okay, so now one of the things I mentioned earlier is that you can have four transitions in one. And what I meant by that is this. We have this transform effect here. If you select these middle keyframes, right-click, keyframe assistant, time reverse, this will move the transition in the opposite direction. So just with these settings here, we have a transition to the right, highlight these middle keyframes, keyframe assistant, time reverse, and now these animate off to the left. Okay, so that's two of our transitions right now. So now the other two transitions are going to go from top to bottom and bottom to top. So let's go back to our effects control panel, select transform and hit return. You can rename this effect. So we're going to say H slide for horizontal slide. And for fast box blur, we'll call that H blur for horizontal blur. Highlight both of these and command or control D to duplicate. And then for H slide 2, let's name that V slide for vertical slide. And then for H blur 2, we'll change that to V blur for vertical blur. Group these together so we have our V slide and V blur together. For V blur, let's just open that up and we have blur dimension set to horizontal. Let's just change that to vertical. So that's easy enough. Okay, and let's go back down to our transition with the layer selected. Click U to bring up our keyframes. Highlight H slide and H blur and just turn those effects off. So that way we only have V slide and V blur. Okay, so for V slide, let's get rid of these keyframes because we need to redo these. So just take those off and we're going to put a keyframe for our 96540 position. Go to where this first keyframe is for H slide and we're going to put a keyframe on our V slide. We want to change this value to 960. So that way this moves up. Okay. And then for this next keyframe here, we're going to change this to 960/1080 because our comp size is 1920 by 1080. So we want this to come in from the bottom and then just go to our last set of keyframes here and just change that back to 96540. And now we need to highlight these keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. And then we want to have the same kind of animation as our others. So that first keyframe, we need to pull the handle over to the right, go to the last keyframe, graph editor, pull it over to the left. So now if we watch this playback, we can see that our transition goes from the bottom to the top. And again, we can highlight these keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse. So that way it goes from the top to the bottom. So with just this set of keyframes, we have the ability to transition left to right, right to left, top to bottom, and bottom to top. And we can save this as an animation preset. So let's select transition. We're going to close that up and then open it back up. Select effect. Go to animation, save animation preset. And make sure you are in your documents, Adobe, the version you're using. I'm using 2020 user presets. I'm going to drop mine in this folder for 7 minute AE. You can create any folder you'd like. And I'm just going to call this multi-transition. Click save. So once you save this as an animation preset, you can bring this into any project. Just add an adjustment layer, trim it to 20 frames, and then navigate to your user presets and apply it at that point. And now you have four transitions in one and another transition to add to your transitions library.
I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project file and presets for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.